Do you know these little sparklines on GitHub? They are very simple graphs that can show the evolution of anything throughout time at a glance. I want to build a sparkline generator in PHP from scratch. The first thing I did was to look at GitHub's implementation. I suspected each sparkline to be a separate SVG, which was in fact correct. And the benefit of SVGs is that they are images written in XML, that's human readable code, meaning you can generate dynamic SVGs on the fly. Now, I like to work backwards to solve these kinds of problems. So I started from an existing SVG and step by step, I added dynamic behavior. I created a blade file containing the SVG code. And next, I created a controller that simply renders that file. First, I experimented with colors. I noticed the GitHub version allowed for a gradient of 4 colors, and I just hard-coded some random ones to start with. I also noticed that each SVG requires a unique ID. So I generated a UUID in the controller and passed it to my blade view. Next, I took a close look at how the sparkline itself was rendered. The SVG contains a bunch of coordinates where each XY pair represents a value. And this is the part I want to fill dynamically based on the daily views per post. First, I just played around with hard-coded values and discovered that the width and height of the SVG is predetermined, 155 pixels wide and 28 pixels high. And these are important numbers because I'll have to rescale my data to fit within these dimensions. I moved these coordinates to the controller and wrote a script to rebase any set of values to the 155 by 28 pixels screen. Let's say one day I've got a value of 900 and the other day a value of 450. Then those values should be converted to 28 and 14. The other variable to determine is the width. We've got 155 pixels to work with and we'll have to space our data points according to the number of values we want to show. With these two conversions in place, we've actually covered the most difficult part. I generated an array with 100 random numbers to test my conversion logic, and it seemed to work great. So now was the time to refactor a little bit. Remember that I want to generate multiple sparklines, one for each post. So I extracted all sparkline-related code to a class. I called it, unsurprisingly, sparkline. The next step was to add configurability. I started by making the dimensions of the sparkline configurable. Instead of a hard-coded 155 by 28 pixels, I want to choose whatever dimensions I need. Since I've already written all the logic to rescale any value set, it will be as easy as pulling out these two hard-coded numbers and making them configurable with the method. I called it with dimensions. Making changes to the sparkline class wasn't enough though, because the SVG itself also had width and height values embedded within. It meant that I had to refactor just a little more code. Right now, the sparkline class simply returned a set of coordinates, but it should actually render the whole SVG so that we can pass dynamic data into the blade view. And after all of that was done, the sparkline class now had a render method that actually rendered the SVG and returned it as a string. There were a couple of other things I could make configurable as well. The stroke width of the line and the gradient colors. And I made sure you can pass in however many colors you'd want and not just 4. So now came the time to start using real data. I added a method called getSparkline to my post model. And its goal is to return a configured Sparkline object with the correct data for that post. I already store post visits in a separate table, so I used Laravel's query builder to write a query that groups visits per post per day. I called the getSparkline method in my list of posts, and it worked. However, there is one big issue. Our Sparkline gets automatically scaled for a given dataset, but that makes it difficult to compare different posts to each other. Where the max value of one post could be 50, it could be 10 for another one. In this case, I wanted all sparklines to have the same scale so that I can compare the performance of different posts. This meant that I had to determine one overarching maximum value across posts and use that as the maximum value for all sparklines. Now, luckily, this was very easy to do. At the moment, the maximum value for one sparkline was determined based on the value for the one instance. So I added a configurable max value variable that would override the default behavior. In my case, the difference might be subtle, but still I'm happy to have this functionality available. That brings us to one last issue though. I want all sparklines to contain exactly the same amount of days. Even if a post wasn't available 20 days ago, I want the sparkline to be present. In essence, that means that I should add another configurable value that overrides the default behavior of simply scaling the sparkline to the number of items in it. If there are more items available than the specified amount, then we'll take a subset of the available items. If, on the other hand, there are items missing, we'll fill out all the empty spaces. Now, behind the scenes, I also added some caching so that I don't need to recalculate everything on every request. And I also extracted all of this code to another package so that I can reuse it in other projects. In fact, you can find a link to that package in the description. I would say this was a nice experiment, and I think the working backwards strategy really paid off. But I would like to hear your thoughts. What do you think of it? Let me know in the comments down below, and I will see you in the next video.